workshop, we'll be learning how to build an embedded system using IoT, right? So for that, first we need to understand about the microcontroller we are going to use here. So the microcontroller we use here is the Texas TIVA C series TM4C123G microcontroller. This is called as also called as a launch pad. And to interface the various sensors with your microcontroller, we are going to use this groove board. Along with this groove board, you are supplied with the various sensors. So the various sensors we have, like humidity sensor, ultrasonic sensor, potentiometer, etc. So based on your requirement, you'll be able to use these sensors with this launch pad. And when required, whenever I want to do an IoT concept, you have to fix this Wi-Fi module on the top of this launch pad, and you'll be able to measure these sensor values and store these values on the plug. Okay. So as a first part, you will first see how to connect this ultrasonic sensor with this launch pad and measure these values on the serial monitor. Right. So for that, we have connected this groove board on the bottom of this microcontroller or launch pad, and through this interfacing cable, we have connected this ultrasonic sensor. In this yellow pin is a signal, white is a clock, which is not required for your analog patch, and black is your ground, and the red is your VCC. So this yellow we have connected to pin number 24. So we use engg software to work with this TIVA C series microcontroller. So we have just written a program to read this analog value from this potentiometer and display it on the serial monitor. So for that, we have to set the baud rate as 9600. And this pin number, now we have to give the signal pin, which is pin number 24. And we are going to read the sensor value. So for that, you have to just compile this program. And upload it. And in here, we have something called as terata. So in your terata, we'll be able to measure the values. So you know the principle of ultrasonic. As the distance varies, your displacement value is going to get varied. So suppose this is an object whose displacement is to be measured. So I'll be varying the distance. You can see the values. It's getting changed. So whenever you are going to change this value, accordingly, here the displacement value is getting changed. Yeah. So this is how we'll be able to measure the displacement. So closer you get a smaller value, and larger you get a larger displacement value.